You are a fucking punk. Nigga puts on the song. Lady Gaga. Yeah, things gonna be okay. These niggas are close to me. Gonna be okay. What the fuck is going on? Welcome. Gonna be okay. Gonna be okay.
I didn't realize that when Fresh and Fit put out that live stream and said they were gonna nuke our channel, they just ended up nuking their own. I don't know why Myron did this, but he decided to go on Sneeko's live stream on Rumble.
Let's see if Pearl's still. You have to wear that too.
Yeah, of course. How am I gonna break this down if I'm not in my proper attire as a racer?
Bro.
All right, can you move over a little bit?
Okay, I'm moving
you
over.
Fucking change.
You see out of that, you fucking sand nigga.
But it's okay.
White supremacist sand nigga.
Shut up. Bro, you're the worst of the worst. You eat dogs and you kill people as a black guy. In Asia.
Yeah, true.
Yo, pause right. This nigga right here is funny. He's funny, this nigga.
I don't condone this N-word.
Oh.
Shut up, you Albanian fat. Keep running the clip, you chink. No, keep running the clip. Who's that weird nigga that can't speak? Who's that? He black as hell. Bate man. Yeah, let's keep going.
I fucking preach. I went lick windows for fun.
Holy shit, who's this gainer here with the red? What the fuck is going on? What in tarnation fucking pussy shit is that?
Rich, you look at it.
In the islands, we say Bunabati man. Straight!
Do you boo boo? Do you boo boo? Oh yeah! I fucking preach! I wear lip windows for fun!
I know that preach name.
Not respect to minorities. What the fuck? Stop!
What?
I want to get another run!
There right now. He punched there probably swinging around eating some bananas. Fucking stupid bitch. Preach is crying right now, swinging from a monkey ranch,
bro.
Eating a banana, playing some Donkey Kong on an N64 because he's a stupid prick. He's a window licking stupid nigga.
What?
What?
Fat ugly white!
Hey.
Oh, that spin. I like that. I like that.
This video that
he
we
got these
to?
Niggas running like it's an employment line.
What the f?
What? Don't do that. I will find you, you fucking stinky looking piece of shit. You go fucking fat right here. I don't like you already.
I don't know how you guys did it, but you guys made a more embarrassing response than H3H3. By like a long mile.
Never ever compare that Myron dude to them fucking Jews, you motherfucker.
Whoa.
Is this a character?
This is not representative.
I was born this way, you chick. Keep going, chick.
No, I don't think they do. So.
You damn right there, high value man. They save more lives than your monkey asses have. What the fuck are you niggas doing? Y'all sitting there in that tight ass room. I'm sitting next to a fucking monkey with dreads for a decade. You niggas
to do now but say, ooh, you
same shitty fucking camera for a damn decade. Retard!
You let me talk shit on the internet. I'm with you. I got a problem with you.
Yo, that nigga called me goofy? Look at you, bro. You're goofy.
Gay! Any man that can boogie is a homosexual.
Same shitty road mic right there. It looks like a penis forever. You guys have not approved nothing, and you fucking niggas. Millionaires now invested back in the business, get called out by a fucking racist KKK member out of Tennessee. You motherfuckers are losers. I'm roasting y'all right now. Continue on, Chang.
Yes. Okay.
Many that nigga sound like he got a 39 IQ. Holy shit. I don't know how this guy preaches, take it seriously. Like, this nigga is fucking stupid. Say Albanian yesterday, he said something about, shut the fuck up, you fucking you stupid nigga. Not showing the women that y'all are with not one time. Last time I checked that, Myron nigga got like 3 or 4 girlfriends, okay? And they're friends with each
other. Or they would hurt our fan base. But if you're secure in who you are.
No, your fan base is a bunch of low IQ feminist that can't take it when you get fit. What does he do? He actually gets fresh and most importantly, fit. That fresh fit nigga helping everybody get in a goddamn shape.
This guy is totally unhinged.
What do you mean? What do you mean I'm unhinged?
You told me the N-word. Watch.
You are an okay, yeah, we do like 10 sets of cross burnings. And here's the thing. I'm going to continue to roast them. They're going to sit there and say, I'm okay, let's fucking go. 10 toes down. I will roast you motherfuckers until the end. You fucking homos got nothing else.
Stop. Reach, I could KO you, but don't fucking throw that spear. These are disgusting animals. That's why they look like animals. These guys are fucking animals, bro. Dude, he fucking runs with all fours like a fucking animal.
Yeah, I think I caught a little. That was a little hardcore. This is a little hardcore even for me.
I'm glad you didn't show up in a white hood, Nick. That would have optics, you know?
I was going to do the MAGA hat, but it wouldn't go as hard as the white hood, so.
Nick, your followers are going to Myron now. You got competition.
That's true. Both of you guys are, it's like I'm being outdone. I thought I went pretty hard in November.
Myron leading the dissident.
No, Reach, I don't even believe in this theory, but you got to evolve. You got to evolve, bro. No. I'm not racist. I'm not racist. I'm half black. I'm half black.
Oh, welcome to Fresh and Prep on the Yo.
Right now.
Yeah, it's a couple of the Albanian and a black guy. Gonna out.
It goes to show how things have changed, because I remember when Dave Chappelle did the Clayton Bigsby shit back in the day, it was fucking hilarious. But nowadays you do that shit, they're like, oh my God. Just goes to show how pussified we've become. After looking at that Donkey Kong photo, I can conclude that he's also a monkey.
Okay.
All right. Like, bro, I'm ready to end them. Like, they want to go here and say, you're a Myron. Cool. Cool. The fucking Arab guy that's also black, that literally, like, I hit so many different check marks for the KKK. Y'all want to call me? Cool, you fucking.
If you're wondering who the white dude in the top left is, that's a white supremacist. Nick Fuentes, who's the leader of a far right movement. And Just Pearly thinks, I will say, Just Pearly thinks orange does look good on you. I'm glad you took Britney's advice. I do think it's funny that the only time you decide to groom yourself is for a clan meeting. But hey, if that's the kind of high-value man you want to attract, go, girlfriend.
Oh, okay. I got some apples and peaches here, as y'all can see. Okay? Some great fruit.
Yeah.
Then we also
apples
got
and peaches.
Some milk as well.
Have you seen how Reach goes clubbing? He clubs the bitch over there like a fucking game, man.
Now, let's fucking do it.
Hey, guys, when we speak, everyone...
Raise your hand. And I think the thing is that they've been kind of coasting on is you got to fight fire with fire.
And we're going to be nice guys. We're going to toss your salad at them.
Bro, no.
We got some accessories here.
Let's go. We're down for what happened.
Let's do it.
Do you realize how dumb everyone has to be? That when you're in a room full of people, that somehow Just Pearly Things seems to be the smartest person. You see her sliding off screen like, what the fuck am I associating myself with? Y'all know how dumb you have to be to make Pearl sound smart.
Prince like uses his head.
It licks it.
Look at it.
Yeah, I mean, hey, listen, if you want to throw away your YouTube channel in the dumbest way possible, cool. You just cost yourself and your staff millions of dollars over one of the dumbest things I've ever seen possible. And also, just notice, all of this rolls off Myra's tongue so easily. This is not the first time he's talked about this, about black people like this. It's not surprising to me.
Yeah. I think we're the first ones really calling them out at this point. They've been lying to y'all for years, and they're dumb fans in the back. Ooh, fresh and fraud, fresh and fraud. Yo, Prince is like a, it looks like a fucking.
You should see him build momentum. What the f***?
Yo, every time this thing,
I got a problem with you.
Imagine them. Yo. Nigga looks like a monkey. Preacher's over there looking like McGilla Gorilla and Donkey Kong having a baby.
Yeah, he's chewing his Ethernet. Hey, Reach. Yo, Reach, you're overdosing on the warrior gene, bro.
Fat ugly white!
I need to dance. I need to get to... That's in my language, too, actually.
You need to put on a seatbelt.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're here, and we will go ahead and get this party started. Boy, oh boy, oh boy, do I have a interesting stream prepared for you. Hit the like button on the way in, hit the Cash App or the PayPal if you support the mission. Your boy's still demonetized, but either way, we're bringing you the content you want, the content you need. And oh Lord, this is going to be one hell of a live stream. Illuminati all through your body. The blows like a 12-gauge shot. Feel me? And God said he should send his one begotten son to lead the wild into the ways of the man. Follow me. Eat my flesh, flesh of my flesh. Come with me. Hail Mary, run quick, see. What do we have here now? We got some tethers running amok, y'all. We got some tethers running amok. If you don't know, if you're a new subscriber, I actually started off on YouTube roasting and exposing and critiquing these incels online that labeled themselves the quote-unquote manosphere. And of course, when I say I did my rounds exposing them, I mean everybody from Kevin Samuels to Anton Daniels to Fresh and Fit to Hannah Pearl Pasty Things, and the list goes on and on and on. And when it comes to Fresh and Fit, good Lord, guys, you might be a little late to the party, but I didn't expose them over 10 months ago. Go check out the original expose if you've yet to see it. From A to Z, I expose these tethers because... God damn it, a tether is as a tether does. Myron Gaines. Fake name. Cosplaying as a black American. He's Sudanese. Former government agent. Fed to be exact. So, first and foremost, we got to make sure that we understand who these cosplaying tethers are that we're dealing with. Myron Gaines, real name. Again, he's a Sudanese. He's a sand nigga, if you will. Real name, Amro Fudil.
My name is Amro Fuddle.
Oh, I'm sorry. He pronounces it Fuddle. That sounds even worse. It's really Fudil. Phonetically, historically, traditionally, it's Fudil. But goddammit, he's ashamed. Goddammit, he has an identity crisis. Goddammit, he doesn't want us to know he's an African Muslim from Sudan. He wants to cosplay as one of you, one of me, a foundational black American. Goddammit, he's so ashamed he won't even pronounce it properly. Fudil. Oh, no, it's not Fudil. For him, it's Fuddle.
My name is Amro Fuddle.
Amro Fuddle. Mm-mm-mm. We got Mr. Fresh Print CEO. Real name, Walter Weeks. Peep game, guys. Peep game. Fit. Cosplaying as Myron. Real name, Amro Fudil. Fresh.
Real name Walter Weeks. Both of them immigrants. Neither of them foundational. And what are they doing with their platform? What are they doing with their content other than leading the young, impressionable minds within our community astray? Let's talk about it, y'all. Let's talk about it. I done exposed these motherfuckers from A to Z. And I moved on. I said, hold on. Why expose two tethers when I can expose hundreds? I can expose thousands. So as of late, my content has been more so focused on history, documentaries, dispelling myths across the diaspora, roasting these tethers who have an identity crisis and are trying to cosplay as us while speaking negative to our reparations claims and other things we're advocating for. And at the same time, running amok, causing a whole bunch of dissension and disarray, and, you know, they're trying to be lumped in with us, so when they do their fraudulent schemes or when they do their crimes, goddammit, it gets lumped in with the Black American statistics, and we're delineating. We're calling spades spades. We're calling Africans Africans. You not Black, remember? You Nigerian. You not Black, remember? You Sudanese. You not Black, remember? You Kenyan. But now when it comes time to get a check, now when it comes time to flee their shithole third world country they are so ashamed of, now all of a sudden they want to be Black. See how that works, y'all. See how it works? So again, let's start with Amru Fudil. Amru Fudil used to be a Fed. Yes, he was an op, as an op is, as an op does, this weird incel anti-Black woman bashing motherfucker was a federal agent, and he didn't want you guys to know that. But now he tries to flaunt the fact that he uses his Fed skills to slam dunk on 304s. But let's talk about it.
I'm actually glad, yeah, because the prior experience like made me really good at, like, you know, do interview, like debating. That's why I listen very closely to what people say, just from, you know, it's good skills to have.
He triggers girls. He triggers the criminals. Hey, you did this, right?
Damn, so he used to be a Fed triggering criminals in the court of law. Now he has a podcast and his bread and butter comes from triggering Black women, more specifically. The majority of the clips and the viral sensations is him trying to slam dunk Black women and then paint them in the worst light possible. And good Lord, he didn't even want us to know at first that he was a fucking Fed, let alone that his real name is what again?
My name is Amber Fuddle.
Yeah, come on, y'all. What are the tethers hiding?
It was fun, man. It was a great career. You know, it sucks that I like kind of had to leave and then I had to, like, you know, tell the truth about it. But
damn, it sucks that you had to stop being a Fed and instead start preaching on a podcast to an army of incels and that you had to tell the truth. Did this fraudulent motherfucker just say that it sucks that he had to tell the truth about his background?
It was fun, man. It was a great career. You know, it sucks that I like kind of had to leave and then I had to, like, you know, tell the truth about it. But
wow, okay, hey, I mean, for those that want to put on a tinfoil hat, if you will, we got a former government agent pops up out of nowhere with a whole bunch of funding in Miami, starts a podcast right at the peak of podcasts in the middle of COVID, and what has he done? What messages has he promoted? I mean, is this a man that plays an active role, or excuse me, are these men, goddammit, these are men, are these boys, are these immigrant little bush babies that are playing an active role in bolstering up prostitution and the sex industry? Aren't all of their panel members porn stars and escorts and IG models? So, goddamn it, all right. If you want to put on the tinfoil hat and say, hey, is this a Fed operation or is this a Fed operation? We got collusion. We got a whole bunch of people colluding behind the scenes with funding that we have never seen before. And what are they doing but promoting sex workers to the youth at the end of the day? And when Mike TV comes around and takes a critical look into their background, I find some strange things. Let's just say I find some really, really strange things indeed.
He don't date Black women because he date boys. Dick in the booty. Dick.
Yeah, he said it, not me. Mike TV does not endorse hate speech against any protected class of people. That includes sexual orientation, gender, immigration status, religion, et cetera, et cetera. Viewer discretion is advised, but goddammit, when I look into his past, I find some strange, strange things.
that nigga gay.
Nigga gay, nigga gay, nigga gay, nigga gay, nigga gay, nigga gay, nigga.
Hey, he said it, not I. He said it, not I. And then when we take a look at the man that tries to call himself the Fresh Prince CEO, the man who modern day is having the baby mama drama with the escort, right? God damn it, these men were never qualified to be dating gurus in the first place. I mean, how many of you guys that follow them and subscribe and pay them money, how many of you guys know that you're taking advice from an immigrant Bush baby who used to be married to a single mother?
All right, guys, so you heard my L's, marrying a single mom, getting left out in the cold, basically in the car, never came downstairs.
Damn. He didn't just marry a single mom. He married a single mom that left him outside in the cold, never came downstairs. Oh, Lord, maybe that's why they hate women so much.
All right, guys, so you heard my L's, marrying a single mom, getting left out in the cold, basically in the car, never came downstairs.
Damn, he got left out in the cold. Cue the sad music. The single mother that he married, wifed up, became a stepdaddy for an errand thing. She left him out in the cold. Oh, Lord, now we know why they have such a gripe, such disdain, such vitriol for the opposite gender. Boy, oh, boy, come on. So what is Walter Week's background? He got rejected by a single mother he booed up, right? He got down on one knee, put a ring on a single mother's finger, and he did not get the outcome that he felt that he expected. So he starts making fake prank videos on YouTube.
Hey, excuse me, where's that Central?
First, no guy who actually owns an exotic car sits on his car like this waiting for nothing. If you're able to afford an exotic, you always have somewhere to go or something to do. Magically, a cute girl just happens to be walking by.
Yeah.
It is down here, the right side.
What happens in these videos is the guy proving that women are gold diggers rents a Lambo for a few hours, typically posts up where there's very little foot traffic so there can be a clear line of sight for the camera, hires an actress, and then stages a gimmicky conversation. He'll ask the girl out on a date, she'll say no, and then when she finds out what car he drives, she'll then agree to the date.
All right, rejected by a single mother, decides to rent a Lambo and start doing fake prank videos and lying about his wealth.
I like your outfit.
Is your car?
Yeah, well, yeah. So like, you know,
nice,
yeah, I do real estate. I also do like, you know, taxes, all that stuff. So, you know, I make money every now and then, you know.
Oh, wow.
Really easy, really simple.
Nice job.
Damn, and they call me the king of receipts. Mike didn't just say that you got rejected by a single mother who left you out in the cold and then you started doing prank videos lying about your wealth. Mike said that and then provided sufficient evidence to support those claims. And when I say that he's lying about his wealth, I mean, goddammit, you told the chicks that you into real estate and stuff, you ballin' like that, but when you were trying to suck off Grant Cardone and be a part of his organization, you told him you only make $30 per week.
How much money did you make last month?
$120.
$30 a week is what you made last month.
Yes, sir. How much money do you want
to
make?
If you go to McDonald's three times, you're broke.
Damn, not Grant Cardone with a dude. If you go to McDonald's three times, you're broke. Grant, you didn't have to do him like that, Grant. You didn't have to do, you know, them tethers love getting gratification from white folks. You know, you didn't have to do him like that, Grant Cardone. Damn. So how is the Bush baby in one video in front of a rented Lambo saying he do real estate and shit, and the next video he trying to be a part of Grant Cardone's organization saying he make $30 per week? Oh, and I'm going to give you guys a little spoiler. Grant rejects his application.
How much money did you make last month?
$120.
$30 a week is what you made last month.
Yes, sir. How much money do you want to make?
If you go to McDonald's three times, you're broke.
You don't have whatever it takes. Not okay. This team.
Okay, thank you.
Good luck to you, all right?
Thank you.
Okay, good luck to you, man. This is what every company in America is going through. We get worn out looking at resumes, so we end up hiring Walter.
Damn, Grant, you didn't have to do him like that, Grant Cardone. You could have just rejected him, said no, thank you for your time. But Grant Cardone said what? He said, this is what companies all over America are dealing with. We get worn out and we got to deal with people like Walter. Damn.
You don't have whatever it takes. Not this team.
Okay, thank you.
Good luck to you, all right?
Thank you.
Okay, good luck to you, man. This is what every company in America is going through. We get worn out looking at resumes, so we end up hiring Walter.
Dang, he said they only hire a Walter if they get worn out looking at resumes. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. But guess what these tethers love to do? They love to fake it until they make it. Fake it till you make it is their ideology. It's their religious doctrine, if you will. It's their creed. It's their motto. Fake it till you make it. So you know what Walter started doing? He started paying for fake press release articles.
Full of pictures representing a fake lifestyle, Walter paid for press releases, paid for Instagram growth, paid to rent a camera to take the picture in front of a random McLaren and jet, and will pay for whatever his fake guru mentor says to buy.
And let me get back over on Emru Fuddle's little bitch ass. Oh, Myron Gaines' little bitch ass. Oh, racist Sudanese Bush baby boy, right? How did Myron slip up so hard that he invited the escort that rejected him, the escort that he tried to pay for? How are you going to slide into an escort's DM on seeking arrangements, try to get with her, she reject you, so you say, okay, do you want to come on my podcast? Why would you do that, Myron, and think that anything other than this would be the outcome?
Apparently, Myron has a sugar daddy profile. Sugar daddy.
Really?
Yes, trying to get the sugar babies, which I don't know why he's doing that, because he's actually coaching men how to be a high value man and how to get women, but he's on the seeking arrangement.
Couldn't even get me to go on the first date with him. He didn't get
receipts.
He got head. He got no pussy. He got nothing for me. You approached me on a sugar daddy website and asked me to be your sugar baby, and then couldn't afford my allowance.
Never did.
He couldn't afford my $10,000 allowance a month and said, "Huh, that's funny. Why don't you just come on my podcast instead?"
Uber.
Stop interrupting. Sorry. So thank you for cementing the fact that I don't pay girls off sugar sites.
Facts.
Thank you.
Then why are you on that?
Because I use it as a dating site. I've said it many times.
No, come on. This is bullshit.
Damn, not Mike TV coming through with the heavy hand of receipts. I mean, y'all might be new to the party of fraud and fishy, of Walter and Emerald, of fresh and fit. Y'all might be new to the party and not understand how fraudulent these men are, how they've been getting exposed for years now. You might think that Walter's little baby mama drama is more than the tip of the iceberg, but nah. This is old news, y'all. This is old news. Myron and Walter, they're incel beta male cuckold simps that use their podcast clout to leverage for sex. Nothing more, nothing less.
Right? Benny's talking to women. He says, "You want to get on this podcast? Well, we can only do it if you fuck. Is that how you conduct your business? Right? How are you giving people business lessons, but you shit where you work? Does anyone find it funny that this man's bad business practices are coming out to bite his business in the ass, and he's giving you guys all the business advice? There's an incongruence here that I find hilarious. How is it a good business strategy to go message a random woman and say, "You want to get on this podcast? I would love to have you on. Let's collaborate." She's like, "Okay, sure. You're like, "Are you single? Because I only work with people I'm banging." Is that a good business practice? Is that burning desire that you mentioned it?
Unlike these idiots, we can actually get girls. These dudes have probably never even smelled a woman.
They've never had genuine burning desire.
Nope.
Because no one wants to eat the fat leftover.
Well, the sex is transactional. We don't have it. But that's exactly what you do.
And you see, the way you acquire a woman sometimes is even more important than acquiring her. And what I mean by that is, you're not going to get her best if you pay for it. Nope. And if you're content with that, that's okay.
Yeah.
But, you know, me and Fresh personally, and this is, man, each guy is different, right? Some guys don't care how they get it. Some guys are okay with paying for it. But like me and Fresh personally, we're like, we want this girl's best. You know what I'm saying?
When you say her best.
We want to own the soul.
Oh boy, not leveraging the podcast to get some pooty tang because you can't get it any other way. Boy, oh boy. Ladies and gentlemen, hit the like button on the way in. Hit the Cash App or the PayPal if you support the mission. Monica, thank you for the Cash App earlier. Big Hank, I appreciate the contribution. Garland, thank you for the support. Oh, and also, guys, if you don't know, now you know, a lot of these tethers have been cutting up on TikTok, and I want to be able to start live streaming on TikTok, and in order to do that, I need 1,000 followers over there. So if you have a TikTok, go follow me. The link is in the chat, MikeTV999. As soon as I get 1,000 followers on TikTok, I can start cutting up over there. But let's get back to the mission at hand. I mean, again, if you guys think that Walter's baby mama drama was some kind of shock and awe, and oh my gosh, this is the end of Fresh and Fit. I mean, these motherfuckers get exposed every other week. And Myron Emerald, he was the first one to have the baby mama drama. Do y'all remember when he had the escort called Miss Cheeks, who had a pregnancy scare, and she was running around telling everybody that Myron was the baby daddy? I mean, a pregnancy scare is just part of the repertoire when it comes to Fresh and Fit. It was about time for Walter to have his pregnancy scare. I mean, Myron had one 3 years ago now, right? It was about 3 years ago.
Juicy bomb that you did drop, and that everybody, all these commentators, okay, all throughout the manosphere and outside the manosphere on YouTube are talking about. Are you really pregnant?
Yes, I'm pregnant.
Is Myron Gaines the father?
Yes, he is.
Okay, not a good look. It's pretty weird when you have a platform shaming women for being modern whores, and you get paid by young impressionable men to give advice on how to get the girl, and really behind the scenes you're leveraging podcast clout for pussy and on seeking arrangements, trying to pay for sugar babies. I mean, all right. Hey, if you can't beat them, join them, right, guys? I should stop exposing these mofos, and I should just become a fake guru myself, and I too can be a millionaire overnight, because there's no shortage of blind incels out there looking for some guidance. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. And let's get back to Walter. I mean, Walter, the same one who said he got left out in the rain and the cold by the single mother he married, right? He now wants us to believe that he's smashing 3 broads in a day.
But today we're going to talk about my W in terms of having 3 women in one day.
Yeah, 3 women in one day, huh?
I wonder if you know that I know he's lying right now. Oh, you got the new Margiela? That's what's up. I see you. That's your BMW? That's nice. That's your girl? Golly. Okay, I see you. But I just want to know one thing. You ready? Why the fuck you lying?
Yeah. Yeah, and you see, Myron is clearly the leader and Walter is the follower. Myron has the baby mama drama. Now Walter has the baby mama drama. Myron gets busted with the escorts. Now Walter gets busted with the escorts. Do you guys remember when Walter got caught paying a escort to be his girlfriend on podcasts? And at the same time, he's lying, claiming that he has 1,000 bodies, 1,000 lay counts, as they say.
My honest to God truth body count, bro. No cap, no filter, no, like, it's over 1,000. I'm dead ass serious.
Damn, even your paid escort GFE girlfriend experience, even your paid actor girlfriend is laughing in your face when you try to tell your followers that you've got over 1,000 bodies. Oh boy, oh boy. And how was DJ Academics, of all people, how is Academics the one trying to walk you from the ledge? He said, yo, Walter, clearly you paid this escort girl to be your girlfriend. Maybe you want to stop doing this before people start exposing you. You're coming off like a bit of a hypocrite.
Fresh, I love you, brother. but I feel like you're walking into the path of becoming what I would say is a hypocrite, or you're just strictly delusional, something that you preach against.
Damn, either you're delusional or a hypocrite. Neither of them are good options. Because again, ladies and gentlemen, Myron wasn't the only one paying escorts. Walter had an escort come on the show for a few months in a row, pretending to be his girlfriend.
Okay, I don't know why I just got this random link. Let's see who this girl is. I mean, she looks pretty good. Her name's D. Milfy. kind of a sus name, 23, female, Miami, Florida. Okay. Let's look through. Wait a second.
Damn, I mean, you're not really being that slick when everybody that you claim that you guys are in relationships with conveniently also have seeking arrangement profiles, right? Come on. Hey, if y'all found Mike TV's old girlfriends and all of them just so happen to have seeking arrangement profiles, I think it'd be safe to say I'm paying for the play. I mean, good Lord. We got the blind leading the blind over here. And now we can get on to the Sudanese Bush baby's apparent anti-black women rhetoric. I mean, he just really despises black women for some strange reason. Listen to the compilation of the Bush baby trying to diss the sisters.
Yeah, let's send him over.
Why is it always the black chicks, bro?
It's always.
Black women have the lowest approval rate of all the other races of women. I'm gonna say that again. Black women have the lowest approval rate of all the other races.
A lot of people in the black community are the most racist of them all. Facts. You continue. My thing is, I don't even look at race. I look at it. Do I respect the person?
If you went back to Africa and you found a beautiful, gorgeous woman that you were attracted to, like, would you date her and marry her?
No, I've told my mom this actually too, because she's asked me. I'm from Sudan. She's like, "Do you want to marry a Sudanese woman?" I said, "No."
Oh, she doesn't specifically have to be Sudanese.
No, but that's where my parents are from. So, okay. Yeah, the answer is no. Like, I have a certain particular look that I'm looking for, and just Sudanese women tend to not match that.
What is the issue with black women?
With all the respect, I don't have to explain. Me and Fresh aren't really down with the brown like that. Man. We ain't night riders.
Nah,
so
bro, I'm good.
You know, sometimes if they're, you know, red bone, but like in general, me and Fresh don't dabble in the dark, if you know what I'm saying.
Yep.
Me and Fresh aren't really down with the brown like that. Man. We ain't night riders.
Damn, not down with the brown like that, he says. We're not night riders. What the fuck kind of clan rhetoric is that? We're not night riders. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord, oh, Lord. All right. Hey, we know they not down with the brown. But we know that the boy Myron is down with the white.
That nigga gay, 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 nigga
gay. He don't date black women, cause he date boys. Dick in the booty.
Hey, he said it, not me. And you know, these tethers have identity crisis. They hate their black heritage. They want to be accepted by white people. Why, when we look at Myron's sugar daddy profile, he's talking about he wants a white girl so he can have some mulatto babies.
I'm just here to find a brunette side chick to compliment my blonde trophy wife that is pregnant with our mulatto baby.
Yeah, so he goes out of his way to say how black women aren't shit and he don't like black women and he's not down with the brown and no night rider and la 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 la.
Black
right?
women have the lowest approval rate of all the other races of women. I'm gonna say that again. Black women have the lowest approval rate of all the other races on dating apps.
Yeah, okay.
Me and Fresh aren't really down with the brown like that. Man. We ain't night riders.
Nah,
so
bro, I'm good.
You know, sometimes if they're, you know, red bone, but like in general, me and Fresh.
All right. I mean, the same ones going out of their way to diss the sisters are going out of their way to put on the profile that they want a blonde trophy wife to have a mulatto baby with, right?
I'm just here to find a brunette side chick to compliment my blonde trophy wife that is pregnant with our mulatto baby.
Okay. Okay. All right. I mean, man typed that out on his own profile. He thought that shit was cool. He thought women would see that and go, "Oh yes, I want a Sudanese man." Okay. So now when we get on to his overt racism, I mean, it's very interesting how this man is on record claiming that black Americans have treated him so badly and black Americans are more racist than white. Black Americans are just so racist, he says.
And these are the tough conversations that people don't want to have, but I'll fucking say it. A lot of people in the black community are the most racist of them all. Facts. You continue. It's incredible to me how like a lot of people in this community like will sit there and, you know, openly talk shit about white people, call them fucking racist derogatory terms, cracker, blah, blah, blah. But, you know, they're some of the most racist people.
So he's dick riding white folks so hard, he's calling Black Americans the most racist people because sometimes we call white people crackers. And meanwhile, this is the slick shit that the San Nigga Sudanese Muslim motherfucker says on the internet about Black folks.
That's probably how he met his wife. And then she looked back at him like, and he's like, and then she's like, and start looking at each other. Probably imagine them getting married.
Pause right. This nigga right here is funny. He's funny. This nigga.
I don't condone this N word.
Oh. Shut up, you Albanian fat. Keep running the clip, you chink. No, keep running the clip. Who's that weird nigga that can't speak? Who's that? He black as hell.
Respect to minorities. What the fuck? Stop!
What?
I want to get another run.
You fucking homos got nothing else.
Yeah, I think I caught a little. That was a little hardcore. This is a little hardcore even for me.
I'm glad you didn't show up in a white hood, Nick. That would have optics, you know?
That's probably how he met his wife. And then she looked back at him like, and he's like, and then she's like, and start licking each other and shit.
Here right now. He punched air properly, swinging around eating some bananas. Fucking stupid bitch. Preach is crying right now, swinging from a monkey ranch.
Bro.
Eating a banana, playing some Donkey Kong on an N64 because he's a stupid prick. He's a window-licking stupid nigga.
Y'all see what happens when we let these immigrants come over here? You see why foundational Black Americans are delineating? You see why we're going out of our way to make sure people know we are us and they are them? Oh, and the whole time they cosplaying as you and me. Amro Fudil calls himself Myron Gaines. Motherfucker call himself Myron. He said, what's a blacker name than Amro Fudil? I'll go by Myron. Walter Weeks? I mean, Lord. Oh, Lord. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you're new to the party, I've exposed these motherfuckers going on 10 months ago, almost a year ago by now. So let's get caught up to speed on what the latest controversy is.
Our boy's in some hot water. He woke up to that I'm late text after he did not strap up with a latex, allegedly that is. And this is the woman who is claiming to be pregnant with his child. She leaked text messages and voicemails that were allegedly from Frogger himself. Basically, the man wants to cross the street without getting hit by a car. He wants to abort the mission. And she's not having any of that. You always told me you wanted me to be your baby's mother. I love you and did everything to be a good girlfriend. Now this is happening. You walked away. I think I want to keep the baby. I don't want to kill alive. I want you to think carefully and take responsibility. So she wants to keep the baby, i.e. she wants a scholarship at the Frogger community for the next 18 years. While on the other hand, he just wants this situation to be over ASAP.
I want the baby because I don't want to kill the baby.
What is up with these folks and their overwhelming levels of zest? Why is it that when Walter finally shoots the club up, it's of a immigrant Asian broad that looks trans, right? I'm glad I'm not the only one who thought a man could have had any kind of woman. He could have had a fine feminine Black American woman, but he goes for the trans-am looking foreign broad with the bolts on titties, everything about her fake, and he's hitting it raw. He hitting the escort raw, y'all. Do you know how nasty, how down bad the escort though? Damn. Meanwhile, he's selling consultations and packages on how to get bitches, but you ain't telling motherfuckers that you hitting escorts raw. Oh Lord, how your dick must burn.
I want to nobody.
You're not. They just give you a pill and it's over.
No, God wants you to have a baby. 7 years never happened, and then you're you're fucking me for a month. And you-
not this motherfucker fucking the trans looking escort for a month raw, caught on voice audio recording trying to advise her to take the pill and abort the baby. Oh Lord, these motherfuckers so down bad.
I'm pregnant.
The funniest part is this all goes directly against everything they preach not to do when it comes to men quote-unquote protecting themselves. They shit on women all day who fit this exact profile to a T. And she actually managed to convince these guys that she comes from money and that she's somehow not a gold digger. He was out here buying her expensive gifts, tricking off his simp subscribers' hard-earned money. And the thing is, this all could have been very easily avoided. She even posts text messages from beforehand where she apparently had another pregnancy scare, and she even told him that he would not be so lucky next time, insinuating that if he continued to shoot up her club, that she would get pregnant.
Hey, I'm not the escort warning him, if you keep shooting my club up, I'm gonna get pregnant next time. Oh, Lord, it was just too good. When these incels, virgins, finally get some pussy, no matter how weird and transforming it looks like, since it's some foreign kudakata hit hotter, the motherfuckers just gotta go in at raw and shoot the club up. They can't help themselves. Yet they try to slam dunk on the women all day and say modern women are whores and this or that, and they choose to lay up raw with escorts.
Of course, after these texts started spreading around online, they had to come in with a response.
We had people come at us. We've had death threats at us. People fucking laugh at every time we fucking go through some bullshit. So you motherfuckers can say whatever the fuck you want to say. I'm not going anywhere.
I mean,
are we supposed to be feeling sympathy for you because you claim you had death threats? You're the same one throwing up Nazi salutes, Myron.
What the fuck? Stop! What? I want to get another one.
Oh, wait, I forgot the white hood. You're in a white hood throwing up Nazi salutes, and we're supposed to feel sorry for you because your boy got caught up shooting the club up of an escort, foreign escort, and now we're supposed to feel sympathy because you claim you've gotten death threats. Okay.
And the man is damn near breaking down in tears over his boy getting a thought pregnant. In fact, he broke down about this entire thing, yelling on his soapbox to the world about how hard their life is creating content on the edge. The thing is, though, guys, this...
Okay. Cue the E42 short, nigga. Don't act like a bitch. I mean, what the fuck? Oh, man, he's real triggered that his bro was going out bad. I mean, and guys, there's so many layers to the debauchery. I mean, you know, if I'm going to be a little candid with y'all, I also enjoy... don't know, man, really like having sex on with the rubber, right? But that's reserved for long-term relationships, and goddammit, there's something called a pull-out game. So the fact that you chose to go in raw in a whore that you've known for less than a week and do that for over a month, have zero pull-out game, and when you get a baby, you supposed to, oh, well, just take that pill, swallow that pill. Nah, she got your ass. Coming to America. She was plotting. She was scheming. She said, well, who is the dumbest motherfucker? Who is the stupidest with the most money? Let me see. Out of all of America, who's the stupidest with the most money? Walter is.
This was not some one-night stand. And while I do think her main motive in this situation is money, an opportunity for a better life, she also had a deeper relationship with this man, even going as far as to meet his mother, apparently.
No! These motherfuckers position themselves like they're modern day pimps selling the game. And in actuality, you bring an escort horse to meet your mama. Come on, y'all. How good was that Asian trans escort punani for him to bring her home to mama? How are you selling the game to young, impressionable men? And what chapter do you advise men to go in raw, shoot the club up of escorts you've known for a couple weeks, and bring them home to mama? Let's just face the truth, y'all. Let's just face the facts head on. He loved this broad, y'all. He loved her. See, this is how you know they tethers and they not foundational Black Americans, because we know you don't try to turn a hoe into a housewife. You don't bring the hoe home to meet your mama. That ain't no part of the game, Playboy. Subscribes to Fresh and Fit is a loser, an incel, a twerp, a nerd, a reject, a beta male cuckold of a man who's just never gonna get what he's after, because Lord, you being led by motherfuckers like this. Okay, he brought the whore home to meet his mama. He got mama smiling. Look, my tether son has brought home an Asian bitch with the perky titties. Oh, yes. Good job, son. Good job. You know, we don't like Black women in this house. We don't like Black people. You brought me an Asian girl. Good job. All right, and now you're going to act like you ain't love that girl? Now you're going to act like you want her to just kill your baby, to just abort the mission? Why you bring her home to mama then, Playboy?
Apparently, you know, in some cultures, I think you meet the mother when they start throwing the rice, they start hearing wedding bells. The way she tells it, the two actually met back in November of last year. She ends up meeting his family, she meets his friends. He defends her from various allegations that his audience had dug up. And she even claims that they had a very serious conversation where he said that she was the one. I mean, the guy was allegedly out here telling her that he loves her.
I love her. No, I don't.
Dang, not you on camera telling the whore you love her and bringing her home to mama. Oh, no. Why you don't want the baby then? Well, because you know that would be one interesting looking baby, huh? That would be one interesting looking baby indeed.
Let me think.
So the baby news dropped. I love you,
babe. Dang, he said, I love you, babe. Oh, Lord. These is the modern day pimps that are leading the young niggas. Hey, this is how you get girls, and you're supposed to have a rotation, and the first Asian escort that he can afford, he talking about, I love you, babe. Mwah.
I love her. No, I don't. Love you, babe.
So the baby news drops. It goes viral. Fresh and Fit react poorly. Like, so bad their lawyer even told them to shut up about it.
But now is not the time to unleash the Kraken here. There is a lot being said right now, and I appreciate, Walter, that you are taking my advice and you are not saying it.
Aubrey and Preach would then interview this mystery pregnant woman. And can we just take a moment to admire the pure pettiness of that entire concept? I mean, talk about pouring salt on the wound of your greatest nemesis. In this interview, Daisy does herself no favors.
Well, he's just making him, like, make him look like an idiot right now, because clearly, like, he made that on public, and on the conversation you saw it, he calls me girlfriend, right? Are you going to take someone to see your entire family if she's not your girlfriend? Travel to your home country? That's not reasonable.
Damn, she took him to the home country. Well, he took her to the home country to meet mama and everything. I think he Caribbean. So he took her to the islands, got on a banana boat to go meet mama. And now he's trying to act like that wasn't his girl. He kissing the whore on the lips, saying, I love you, babe. And now that ain't his girl. All right.
I ask her, well, why do you not want to be intense about monogamy, but you are rushing to have a kid?
Yeah, I understand, because I just felt like I'm not I just feel like I'm not that type of girl that I have to be with someone for years to get married. Or if I like someone, I can have a kid with him for like a week.
So I do not find her to be trustworthy at all when it comes to her motives or how much she apparently loved Frogger. She says a whole lot of nothing here, but did provide some receipts and evidence of the depth of their relationship. The funniest thing to come out of this situation, though, is when Fresh and Fit try and now say this chick is an escort who likes to con men out of their money.
Now it makes
sense. Yes, guys. Now they're on the defense, and their defense is claiming... Oh, hold on, guys. Oh, this is how fucking wild it is. Their defense is claiming the girl is a escort. We already knew she was an escort, Playboy. We already know you can only get women that you can afford. You're paying for the GFE girlfriend experience. We all knew it was a whore that you bought and paid for. So how are you trying to defend the baby mama drama allegations by saying, well, guys, don't trust her. She's just some escort whore. This makes it worse. So you're admitting that you're shooting up Raw in an escort whore, taking her to meet your mama, taking her to your home country. And now your defense is, hey, guys, don't believe her. She's a whore. Why are you with a whore? What part of the game that you teach to young men is pay for a whore and bring her home to mama? I don't get it. These motherfuckers running around saying, guys, don't believe her. Don't believe her because she's a whore. And everybody's running with that narrative. And I'm one of the only ones saying, why are you sleeping with, shooting up in whores to begin with? Especially when everything you preach and the courses you sell speak to the opposite of that.
It's a whole lot of nothing here, but did provide some receipts and evidence of the depth of their relationship. The funniest thing to come out of this situation, though, is when Fresh and Fit try and now say this chick is an escort who likes to con men out of their money.
Now it makes sense why she has these phone numbers contacting her. Now it makes sense why she's on video negotiating prices for certain favors. But then she's running around and telling Abba and preaching all these other simps, oh, I'm going to escort, and they're believing it. Oh, okay, I believe it. Hey, man, like I said before, the truth will always come out.
Which were the very allegations their audience had levied against her when they first popped out on their podcast together.
She still took pictures that an escort would take. So she's still a hoe. And you gave a hoe a $30,000 bracelet, Fresh, so that's a hell. You got exposed.
Yeah, I mean, I love how their own audience keeps roasting him. He says, yo, your girl is clearly an escort. You gave a hoe a $30,000 bracelet. You just got exposed. And they were defending it then, saying, oh, no, she's not a hoe. She just took some risque photos. That's just Fresh's girlfriend. And now it's, hey, guys, don't believe her. She's a hoe, dude. All right, which one is it?
Her. Now it makes sense why she's on video negotiating prices for certain favors. But then she's running around and telling Abba and preaching all these other simps, oh, I'm going to escort, and they're believing it. Oh, okay, I believe it. Hey, man, like I said before, the truth will always come out.
Which were the very allegations their audience had levied against her when they first popped out on their podcast together.
She took pictures that an escort would take. So she's still a hoe. And you gave a hoe a $30,000 bracelet, Fresh, so that's a hell. You got exposed.
Yo, I saw pictures of her on an escort site where people clearly stole her photos and put her there. Bro, she's f***ing Miss China, dude.
Damn. Y'all know more to the story than I do. Who was it in the chat? Who it was? Nick said, wasn't he claiming she was from a rich family from China? Yeah. Their own audience says, hey, yo, you're with a whore, dude. Myron tries to run defense for him and say, hey, no, bro, someone stole her photos and put him on an escort site. She's Miss China, y'all. She's Miss China. Now it's, don't believe her, guys. She's a hoe. Ah, these motherfuckers. Hey, they will continue to fail forward because their audience are imbeciles. It's the blind leading the blind. They can't go wrong. When it's the blind leading the blind, how can you do wrong? They blind, right?
The pictures that an escort would take. So she's still a hoe. And you gave a hoe a $30,000 bracelet, Fresh. So that's a hell. You got exposed.
Yo, I saw pictures of her on an escort site where people clearly stole her photos and put her there. Bro, she's fucking Miss China, dude.
She's fucking Miss China, dude. Bro, like, Walter got fucking Miss China. Like, that's Miss Ling 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 Fao right there. Like, dude, that's Miss China, bro. And now it's, don't believe her, guys. She's an escort.
At the end of the day, admitting that about her just means that he fell in love and was prepared to have a child with not only a woman who he just met, but a woman who it should be apparent from the very jump, like the first second you see her, what she is most likely about. The red pill god himself potentially got by the oldest trap in the book. And I can't say I did not see this coming, as he's not exactly the brains of this operation. This other guy is out here likely putting hot sauce in his condoms and shit. And you know Myron is so pissed off about the optics of this garbage. He even suggests at this point that he is going to get her deported from the country for just bringing this entire situation about.
And you best believe, I'm calling immigration on you.
Damn, not the federal agent, not federal customs homeland security agent telling the escort, you done fucked up and exposed my mans, my mans, my mans, my mans. Now we gonna get you deported. Lord, it gets worse. It'll never get better.
Country for just bringing this entire situation about.
And you best believe, I'm calling immigration on you. 100%.
At the end of the day, these guys are just a couple of goofs. I think that I've finally let go of the fact that they were willing to have my channel deleted to send.
Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I put a poll in the chat. I ask you if you want to see me roast the Manosphere more often. You know, lately I've been doing different content. I haven't really roasted the Manosphere in quite a while. It looks like out of 172 votes, most of you say, yes, get back to roasting them frauds. So I will do just that. I will do just that. This is wild. The evidence is overwhelming. They should not have a single subscriber. No one should be paying them for any kind of relationship advice. They should have ICE called on them. And damn, what part of the game is paying for an escort, getting her pregnant, trying to coerce her into an abortion, and now trying to have your ex-federal agent friend get her deported? All right. This is some tether on tether violence, y'all. This is some tether on tether on tether on tether. Hey, the Abram Preach versus Fresh and Fit was already tether on tether on violence, right? Now it's tether on tether on tether. Come on, come on, come on. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, hit the like button, hit the Cash App, hit the PayPal if you support the mission. We're going to segue into the next live stream. As soon as this stream ends, don't go anywhere. There's going to be a 10-second countdown. And then the next stream is going to begin automatically. And what if I told you? What if I told you that speaking of tethers, speaking of bush babies, the next stream is about a Nigerian scamming ass African man. This is literally a Nigerian, but fuck it. This is an African here that claims that Black Americans owe Africans reparations. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We're going to be doing a few streams tonight. Don't go anywhere. As soon as this stream ends, there's going to be a 10-second countdown. It's going to automatically redirect you into the next stream where we're going to be reacting to this bush baby African man claiming that us foundational Black Americans owe the Africans reparations. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. I'll see you over there in just a moment. Don't touch that dial.